Hi guys, welcome back, and if you're new here, my name is Selena Pereira. I love makeup and I'm from Sydney, Australia. Today's video is going to be on this look that you see right here, which is going to be my Valentine's Day look. I wanted to do something that is still really flattering on everyone and that everyone can do, something that's still really wearable. The beauty as well of this look is that you can take whatever I've done on the top part of my eyes and not even worry about the lower lash line. You can do something really neutral there if you like. And I thought I would keep it really Valentine's themed by bringing you a little bit of a pop of colour on the lower lash line. In this video, I also thought I would do something different. I did a voiceover in my last video and I thought that I would do a talk through in this one. So I'll be talking while I'm actually applying the products. Let me know down below what you think. Give this video a thumbs up if you like those kinds of videos and I'll definitely do more of them. So if you guys want to see how to achieve this look, then please keep on watching. All right, so I already went in and did one eye off camera and I'm just going to take my MAC Soft Dota Paint Pot just with my Morphe G34 brush. And I'm just applying that straight onto my eye. And this is going to be my eyeshadow base. Once that's done, I'm going to be taking the Too Faced Semi Sweet Chocolate Bar palette and I'm going in with the color Coconut Cream, this one right here, and I'm applying that all over my eye from my lid to my brow bone. And I really love this palette. I actually just picked it up recently and I'm just surprised it hasn't had that much hype. I feel that the Too Faced Original Chocolate Bar palette and the new Peach palette has had a lot of hype, but this one is really amazing. Now for a transition color, I'm gonna go in with two shades. I'm gonna go in here with the color Peanut Butter and the color Mousse. And the reason I'm going in with these two colors is because one is a little bit more cool tone, one is a little bit more warm tone, and I feel that together they're gonna give me the perfect color. And I'm just using my Morphe M504 brush to apply this. About this palette too is that it is mostly neutrals, so it's a really good everyday palette and it's something that everyone will get use out of. I also feel that the neutrals that it does have, there's a mix of both warm and cool tones as well, so everyone can use it. Alright, now I'm going to go into the colour Truffled, which is this colour right here, and I'm going in with my Morphe R38 brush. And I'm just taking that and I'm first going to apply it to the outer corner. And then going into the crease as well with that. And like I said, I'm just using windshield wiper motions and circular motions as well. Now I'm going into the shade Pudding, which is this shade right here in the middle. And I'm using my MAC 286 brush. And I'm just going to apply that to the outer corner mainly. And then going into the crease. But mainly in the outer corner. And it's just going to add a little bit of definition. And then I'm going to go into the color Licorice, which is this shade here. Now it looks black, but it's really more of a charcoal. And I'm just going to take my BH Cosmetics Tone Brush. And I'm just going to put this just on the outer corner here. Just kind of on the lash line, more on the outer corner, and then just take that a little bit into the inner corner, just like that. And to blend that out, I'm going back in with my Morphe R38 brush. And especially when I'm working with dark shades, I like to go in with a small brush to kind of apply the color. And then I like to go in with a blending brush to blend it out. And the reason that I do that is because that way I can control how much color I'm applying. And I feel that if I was to just go straight in with that dome brush and just try to blend out the color, I feel like it would get really muddy really quickly. And I feel like, again, I get a lot more control, but the end product becomes a lot better, I find. So now I'm going to go in with my, just an Urban Decay flat brush. And this is just their flat shadow brush. And I'm going to take the color Butter Pecan, which is this shade right here. It's just a light kind of cream shade, just with a little bit of shimmer. It's kind of like a goldy kind of flex shimmer, and I just like to apply that just to the inner third of my eye. And I'm going to apply another color over the top of this as well, so it's just like a bit of a base. So over the top of that, I'm going to spritz my brush with a little bit of Fix Plus, and over the top, I'm gonna take my MAC Nylon. And this is a good old shade. This This is just such a gorgeous shade. I love this color so much. It's gorgeous on the eyes, and it's gorgeous also at cheekbone highlight, and you can just see how amazing that is. So I'm just applying that over the top, just using that brush wet. And then once I've applied that, I'm going to go and apply it with my finger. And the reason that I'm going to do that is because my eyelids tend to crease quite easily. If I don't go over wet products with a dry product, I feel that it's just going to crease and it's going to go everywhere. So it's not what we want. I'm going to go back in with my Morphe R38 brush and I'm just going to blend all that out. And I'm really just concentrating the blending just between the two shadows meet, just that way it's not too harsh, and obviously that inner corner as well. Now I'm going to go on to lashes. So I'm going to first take my Benefit Roller Lash, and I love this mascara. Again, it's one of those ones I picked up the other day after hearing so much about it, and I wish I had picked it up sooner. It is such a beautiful mascara. With my lashes, I want my mascara to separate my lashes and make them long and really dark. I like volume, but I guess my biggest, the biggest thing that I look for in mascara is for my lashes to be really nice and separated and long. And I feel that this mascara does that really nicely. Now for lashes, I'm going to take my Velour lashes in the style Flash It. And that's what they look like right there. They're really nice and flirty, and they've got a little bit of drama, as you can see, but they are still really nice and flirty. What I also like to do is, see how there's these little end bits of the lash. When I trim them, because they are too long for my eye, so when I trim them, I like to keep these little bits. And the reason is because, first, these lashes aren't cheap, so I want to use as much as I can. But secondly, if I want a little bit of extra drama, what I'll do is I'll take that end bit and I'll just apply it to the end of the lash, and I feel it just gives that lash a bit of oomph. Today I'm not going to do that because I like the look of it being like this, just really nice and flirty. And for my glue today, I'm going to use my Ardell lash glue. Now this glue I tried ages ago. I just bought it because I actually just needed a glue just in a bit of an emergency situation. So I bought this glue out just at a store, and I was amazed by how well it worked, and then for some reason I couldn't find it for so long, and I've just recently found it again, which makes me so happy because it is really good and it's really, really cheap as well. So when I apply my lashes, I like to kind of look down into the mirror and just like to pop them on there. And I'll do the outer corner first, and then what I'll do is I'll just attach that in a corner. Oh, by the way, that's the lash glue that I was talking about. So just their Ardell clear glue. Clear lash glue. So that is the top part of the eye done. I'm going to go into the face and then we'll return into the bottom lash line. All right, guys, so that is the top of the eyes. We're going to go do the face and then I'll come back and we'll do the lower lash line. To start off with, I'm just using my makeup eraser just to remove any fallout from my under eyes. I'm just going to use my Skin Therapy Dragon's Blood Moisturizer. And when you're applying products like this, always make sure that you have to clean. Then I'm going in with my Guerlain Gold Primer. I love this primer. It gives you some really, really nice lifts to the face, and I like to use this especially when I've got special events. I just apply it to the face and especially to the forehead where I've got a couple of fine lines. So I'm using my Sephora Smoothing Primer, and this is really similar to the Smashbox one, very similar to the Benefit Professional. And I'm just going to take this just in this area right here because this is the only area that I really have a real issue. And I find as well that my makeup breaks up in this area. It doesn't get oily necessarily. It just breaks up and just fades away in this area. So this just helps to avoid that from happening. And then I'm also just going to take my Marabescu facial spray. This is the facial spray. This is the aloe vera herb and rose water one. I love this spray. This is an amazing spray underneath your makeup. You know, just during the day to freshen up or even as part of your skincare routine. And it is really, really affordable. Those of you that live in Australia, you can buy it at Mecca. I kind of, when I spray this, I kind of try to avoid my eye makeup. It's not going to make a difference to my eyes, but you really want to concentrate on the skin and on the face. Going in with my Hourglass Vanish Stick Foundation, and I'm using the color Buff. And this one, I just recently picked this up, and I'm so glad I did. I've been looking at it for ages, and it is so, so nice. I'm going to use my oval brush. This is my one from Simple Glam Girls. I absolutely love it. And this is my oval brush from Simple Glam Girls. I really like their oval brushes. I find that they're really nice and soft, really luxurious feeling. They're pretty cost effective as well, because the Artiste brushes are quite expensive. And I just really like the finish that this gives me. If you guys do want to save a little bit of money, please be sure to use my discount code. It's just Selena. It's just down below. I always leave it down below. And yeah, they're just really nice brushes. They've got a whole bunch of other products too. They have their version of the Silly Sponge. There's just heaps of different sets for the oval brushes. They've got sets tailored to eyes, sets tailored to face. They've got the Rose Collection. They've got a few other collections as well. I have the entire Rose Collection, and I really like their brushes. So be sure to use my code if you do want to save some money on those. Foundation is blended. I'm just going in with my Tarte Shape Tape Concealer in the color Light Neutral. I'm just going to dot this under my eyes, on my forehead, down the bridge of my nose, and on the cupid's bow. And to blend that out, I'm using my Real Techniques Beauty Sponge. And I'm going to start off with my forehead, the bridge of the nose, and my cupid's bow. I like to leave my under eyes for last. Just feel like it helps to get a little bit more brightness. So I kind of like to let it sit there for a bit. And guys, I really like using the Real Techniques Beauty Sponge. I have heaps of beauty blenders. I've been using Beauty Blender for so long, and only a few months ago did I switch to the Real Techniques one because I thought I would just try it. And I'm just amazed by how well it works. It is slightly cheaper. The Real Techniques one is a little bit cheaper than the Beauty Blender. I don't know how much it is in Australia. In America, I think it's almost half price or something. In Australia, I don't know if it's that much of a difference. But I know that it is a little bit cheaper, the Real Techniques Beauty Sponge, but I just really like it. I really like the way that it works. So now I'm just going to bake my under eyes. I'm just going to use my RCMA no color powder. I've just got it in a Dermablend little container, just because the container from RCMA is not the best. And I'm just going to apply this just over where I apply that concealer. And I'm just going to bring it down to that little problem area that I was talking about before with my makeup breaking up. I find that the smoothing primer and this together really helps to keep the makeup in place, makes it not move, but still does look natural after I apply, you know, everything else. So I'm just applying this everywhere that I applied that concealer. And I'm also going to take just whatever's left on my sponge, and I'm just going to take it over my eyebrows, because I do have a couple of fine lines here. And I just find that by using the powder, it's going to help to kind of blur that out. Just taking a bit on the cupid's bow as well. In the meantime, I'm going to contour. So I'm taking my Kat Von D Shade and Light palette. This is another one of those things that I have been meaning to get, and I didn't get it, and I'm so glad that I did now. The colours are amazing. I can actually see myself using all the colours, even the darker shade I can see myself using. The formula is awesome on these, and the banana shade is so pigmented. I'm amazed by this. So I'm going to take my Morphe M527 brush to these two here, which is Shadow Play and Subconscious, I think. And just tap off the excess, and I'm just going to use that to contour. Now, what I like to do whenever I contour is I kind of like to almost bronze first, And I like to use this kind of a big brush. And what it does is it kind of gives me a transition for my contour, a bit like you would use a transition shade for your eyes. I like to use this brush and kind of more warm tones as like transitions for my contour. I just feel that when I go in and apply my contour, it's not just, you know, a sharp unblended line. I feel like when I go in and put my contour, I've got that fade between that really dark and kind of coming up to a really nice warm shade and then to my skin color, which is what I like personally. And so to contour, I'm gonna take the shade Somber, which is this dark shade here, and I'm gonna take this on a Morphe R5 brush, and I'm just gonna tap off that excess. And just with the point, I'm just gonna start off just here at the back of my contour, and I'm gonna kind of draw a line and then use circular motions to blend that out and bring it towards the front of the face. And for me, I don't really need to contour my hairline too much because I don't really have a big forehead, so I just dust whatever's kind of left. And I just take a little bit as well and just apply it under my lip. And it just gives you the effect that your bottom lip is bigger. Now I just take a little bit of this on the jawline and on the chin just to chisel it out a little bit. Now I'm going to underbake, and basically I'm just going to take that same RCMA No Colour Powder on my Beauty Blender and just apply it straight under my contour just to clean that up a little bit. And I like to bring it all the way down to my chin area. And I don't like to leave it on for too long, so once it's been sitting there for about a minute or so, I just go in and just dust that all away. And I'm just using my Morphe E48 brush, and I'm going to use the same brush, and I'm going in to my Kat Von D Locket Powder, and I'm just going to use that just to kind of wipe away this bakage. And the reason that I like to take this powder is because this powder has, it's such a finely milled powder, and it almost has these little tiny specks of, I'm not going to say glitter, but like shimmer. So it gives this beautiful luminosity to the skin, and I find that when you bake you lose that luminosity, so it's nice to just bring that back a little bit. And it's so subtle, so it doesn't look like glitter on your face, it just looks like you've got some dewiness to your skin, which is what we all want. So now that that's done, I'm going to take my Morphe E4 brush, and I'm going to take my Morphe 9N blush palette, and I'm going to go in to, I think I'm going to go into this colour and this colour. It's kind of nice peachy shade and this kind of more rose shade. The peach shade does have a little bit of shimmer in it. That's why I'm going to go in with that other rose shade to kind of cancel that shimmer a little bit. And I'm just going to stamp that onto the cheeks like so. So after blush, I'm going to go in with highlight. I'm going to go in with my Jeffree Star Skin Frost in the colour Princess Cut. I'm using Sarah because it's pink, and it's going to go nicely with what we're going to do on that lower lash line. So I'm just taking some of that, and I'm just going to apply it to the top part of the cheekbone. So I'm just taking that and just applying it to the top part of the cheekbone. Now, personally for me, I really like to sit my highlight really on that top part of the cheekbone. I don't really like to bring it down too much. I just like it to sit around this area, and you can see just how nice that looks just there. And that's just in general for my highlight. That's where I like to apply in general. And now I'm just going to apply it just up here. Just a little bit on the center of my forehead, just here. And to the bridge of my nose. And a ton on my cupid's bow. So now I'm going back in with the eyes. I'm going to go in and do the lower lash line. I decided to do it after the face because, okay guys, so now we're going back into the eyes, and I'm just going to go and do the bottom lash line. And the reason that I do it after my face makeup is because this way I don't ruin all the work I've done on the lower lash line. So I start off with, I'm just going to take a white eye pencil, and the one I'm using is from a crown brush, And this is in the color Blizzard. I'm just taking that in the waterline and also kind of slightly down. And then I'm just going in with this teensy tiny brush. This is from Morphe. This is the E36 brush. It's really, really small. And I'm just going to go in and I'm just going to blend that out. And straight over that with the same brush, I'm going to go into the Jeffree Star Beauty Killer palette. And I'm going into the color Star Power. So I'm just taking a little bit of that. This is super pigmented, guys. I'm just going to apply it straight over the white. And what that white base has done, it makes the color more pigmented, but also creates a sticky base for it to lay on. So I'm not going to get a lot of fallout. So it's going to prevent me from getting fallout. It's going to prevent me from getting any fallout. And it's going to also last all night long. Which is the same on the other eye. I'm gonna go back in with the color Mousse and I'm gonna apply that underneath, and that's gonna help to blend out that pink shape. You can definitely leave the pink unblended, but I just want to blend it out a little bit just to make it a little bit more wearable. All right, and then just going in with my Morphe M433 brush and taking the color Peanut Butter and doing the same thing, just blending that out a little bit more. And what I like to do is I always like to bring that all the way up so it matches up with my eyeshadow on the top lash line. Now I'm just going to go in one more time with that same Star Power eyeshadow. And I'm going to use that same brush. And I'm just going to very lightly go over that. I'm just going to apply that same Benefit Roll Lash Mascara to the bottom lash line. And this honestly just brings the whole look together. I take that same Princess Cut shade by Jeffree Star Cosmetics, and I'm going to use my Morphe R41 brush, and I'm going to take that into the inner corner. And onto the brow bone. And that is the final eye look. Now moving on to lips. Now you can really honestly do whatever kind of lip color you want. You can do pink, you can do red, you can do nude. I'm going to do nude for today, and I just can't pick between these two shades. I think I'm going to go with this one. So I'm taking the Beauty Bakery Lip Whip in the color Lacta Chai Chai. And guys, I'm telling you, this stuff is smudge proof, transfer proof, long lasting. This will last you all night long. I absolutely love the lip whips from Beauty Bakery. I have so many of their colors. They're metallic ones, they're matte ones, they're all so amazing, and they honestly last all night long. You can eat whatever you want, you can kiss whoever you want, you can do whatever you want in these lips. They will not budge. And the only thing that I find that takes them off at the end of the day is coconut oil. That's the only thing that gets rid of them. They do have a remover that you can buy that is designed to remove their lip whips, but if you don't have that, coconut oil just works absolutely fine. And the brand itself, Beauty Bakery, is such an amazing brand. They've come out with highlighters, they've come out with a eyeshadow palette, they're coming out with a powder that's designed for baking. They're coming out with a foundation as well, primers. They're coming out with really everything, and they're such a cute, innovative brand, and everything is relating to food in some way, which is just so cute and so clever and so creative. I just absolutely love it. So if you want to check out their brand, I recommend that you do. I'll leave a link down below to their website. All right, guys, that is the final look. I really hope that you enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Give me a thumbs up on this video if you liked it. And also don't forget to comment down below with what you want to see next. Thank you guys again. I love you, and I'll see you on the next one. Mwah.